to my father.
Hallelujah.
In my father's house, there are many servants. In my father's house, there are many food. In my father's house, there is no suffering. Why should I live out here and suffer? I will go back.
Hallelujah.
To my father's house. Praise the Lord. And when he came, the Bible said the father received him back.
Amen.
He received him back. He said, my son, you were lost, but now you will be found. I am glad you are home. And the Bible said that the father gave an instruction that the fattest of the animal was slaughtered, and there was a joyous jubilation in the father's house. Why? Because the son that went away had come back. Praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. Look into your neighbor's eye and tell him or her, Egypt has nothing good for you. Don't allow your flesh to lead you back or to Egypt. Hallelujah. I say, hallelujah. Let's go to Numbers. Numbers chapter 13. We are reading the verse number 26 downwards. Are we all there?
The Lord.
Hallelujah. I read. It says, now they departed and came back to Moses and Aaron and all the congregation of the children of Israel in the wilderness of Paran at Kadesh. They brought back word to them, to all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. Hallelujah. Then they told him and said, we went to the land where you sent us. It truly flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. Nevertheless, the people who dwell in the land are strong. The cities are fortified and very large. Moreover, we saw the descendants of Anak there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the south. The Hittites, the Jebusites, and the Amorites dwell in the mountains, and the Canaanites dwell by the sea and along the bank of the Jordan. 13. Then Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and take possession, for we are well able to overcome. Amen. Praise the Lord. But the man who had gone up with him said, we are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we are. And they gave the children of Israel a bad report. The land which they had spied out, saying, the land, though which we have gone as spies, is a land that devoured its inhabitants. And all the people whom we saw in it are men of great stature. Then we saw the giants, the descendants of Anak, came from the giants. And we were like grasshoppers in our own sight. And so we were in their sight. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is the flesh that will tell you that you cannot succeed, when God is telling you that you can succeed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is the flesh that will speak louder unto you that you cannot succeed, when God is telling you that you will succeed. When the children of God went to spy on the land. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They came back, and all what they were saying and telling, the report that they were giving, was that we are not able. We don't have the capability. We don't have the capacity, hallelujah, to possess the land. Amen. Amen. But meanwhile, God has told them that I am taking you to inherit the promised land. Hallelujah. But instead of them believing in the word and holding on to the word of God, they allow the flesh, hallelujah, to dictate unto them that you are not able. Hallelujah. Whenever you face a situation and you are hearing that you are not able, know that the flesh is at work. Praise the Lord. I said, know that the flesh is at work. Praise the Lord. Instead of the children of Israel being in the spirit but believing God to possess the promised land, hallelujah, they resorted to the flesh by disbelieving in what God has told them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They allow the flesh to dictate for them. Amen. When they got to the promised land, they saw the giants. The giants were there. The Anakims were there. Hallelujah. They saw that the cities were fortified. Praise the Lord. And when they look at themselves as people that are coming from the desert with no weapons, hallelujah, and the people fortifying themselves, hallelujah, how are we going to be able, praise the Lord, to overtake? How are we going to be able to possess? How are we going to be able, hallelujah, to possess that which God has promised to give unto us? So they were looking at the impossibilities. Hallelujah. They were looking at the impossibilities. Praise the Lord. And that was the work of the flesh. The enemy will always seek to draw you, hallelujah, on his side. And the side of the enemy is always the works of the flesh. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. He will draw you on his side, and at the moment you find yourself on the side of the enemy, then it means that you are in the flesh. Praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The children of Israel said to themselves, we are not able, but God has told them that I am giving you the land. What is it that God has told you that is giving up to you, that you are looking down upon yourself, that I am not able? Hallelujah. Don't resort to the flesh. When God said it, he meant it. Praise the Lord. So take hold of the word. Hallelujah. Take hold of the word. Believe the word and tell yourself that I am able. I am able to overcome. I am able to succeed. Tell yourself that I will not fail. Hallelujah. Because the greater one is on my side. So no matter the trial that the enemy bring on my way, I know that my Redeemer lives. I will not fail. Hallelujah. I said you will overcome. I said you will overcome. I said you will not fail. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Whatever purpose that God has placed over your life, whatever be the purpose that God has spoken unto you, that I want you to fulfill this purpose, I speak over your life that you will not fail. You will fulfill your purpose. I said you will fulfill your purpose.
Amen.
I said your purpose will come true.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It is the flesh said it is okay to go after somebody's husband. Praise God. Amen. It is the friend that said it is okay when you are with somebody's husband, when you are with somebody's wife. Hallelujah. The flesh will always pamper you. It is nice. Remain there. Amen.
Amen.
That is what Samson did. Praise the Lord. When Samson received the word of God, instead of Samson being focused and walking in the light of the word of God, hallelujah, Samson resulted in following women. Hallelujah. He resorted to the flesh. And so far as he was in the flesh, oh, to him, it was okay. Whenever you find yourself, hallelujah, saturated in the things of the flesh, you feel okay. Because you've seen yourself so much in the flesh that the flesh has become part and parcel of you. Praise the Lord. You have killed the conscience of the Holy Spirit. So no matter how the Spirit of God rebukes you, no matter how the Spirit of God deals with you, because you find yourself deeply in the flesh, you are not able, hallelujah, to come out. Samson, hallelujah, found himself with women. His problem was women. Hallelujah. That was what the flesh, hallelujah, working against him. That was the flesh that was working against Samson. Women. Praise the Lord. So when Samson had detected that this is what the enemy is using against my life, the enemy is using women to prevent me from fulfilling my purpose, Samson should have given a break. Hallelujah. And work on himself. Praise God. But Samson allowed himself to be overtaken, hallelujah, by the flesh. Amen.
Amen.
I say amen.
Amen.
It is the only flesh. Hallelujah. The flesh that can cause you not to see that which God has purposed for your life. Praise the Lord. It is the flesh that will tell you to be angry when God says you don't have to let your anger lead you to sin. Praise the Lord. It is the flesh that will tell you to be angry when God is saying that you don't have to allow your anger, hallelujah, to lead you to sin as a child of God. Praise the Lord. It happened in the life of Moses. We have just read. Moses became angry. And because of his anger, hallelujah, he could not fulfill that which God has purposed for him to achieve. Praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. Don't resort to anger. Anger is normal. We are humans. You will get angry. But in your angry, don't sin. Hallelujah. Don't go and sleep over your anger. When you become angry and you go to sleep, come back with that anger not being in you. Praise God. If you ponder on your anger, if you ponder on your anger, if you entertain the anger, which is flesh, the anger will lead you to where you might not be able to see the glory of God. Hallelujah. God has called us together. Hallelujah. To bless our lives. But if we can see the fullness of the blessings of God, if we can attain and achieve the purposes of God in our life, then we need to deal with the flesh. Praise the Lord. We need to do what? To deal with the flesh. Praise the Lord. Why is the flesh most of the time alive in us? Why is it that most of the time we see the flesh fighting against our members? Paul spoke about it in Philippians. He said that the thing that I want to do, I'm not able to do. But the thing that I don't want to do, that is what I see myself doing them. Praise the Lord. Why is it that we see ourselves, hallelujah, most of the time, walking in flesh? Why is it that the flesh appeals unto us so much? Hallelujah. The flesh is alive in us because we don't agree with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. If you don't agree with the Holy Spirit, then the flesh will show up in you. Praise the Lord. But when you are going through a situation, when you are in a dilemma, whereby you know that this dilemma that I find myself in is from the flesh, anytime that you find yourself in such a situation, hallelujah, the Holy Spirit will come in. He will come and speak unto you. But when we hear the voice of the Spirit, agree with the Holy Spirit. Praise God. If you can agree with the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, the flesh will not have a place in your life. If you can agree with the Holy Spirit, hallelujah, the flesh will not be able to dominate your life. When you are going through problem, hallelujah, when the enemy shows up with the flesh, and when the Spirit of God speaks unto you, praise the Lord, agree with the Spirit. Praise the Lord. Sometimes the Spirit of God speaks unto us, and instead of us agreeing with the Spirit of God, we don't agree with the Spirit. Hallelujah. A woman, a Christian, a sister in the Lord, tongue talking, born again, full of the Spirit of God. Praise the Lord. You go and you dress up. And as you are dressing up, you know, you are copying the dressing of the people of the world. And then you dress, you finish paintings, you know. Yeah, it's good to paint, it's wonderful. But, you know, you have to do it the way that presents you as a child of God. Praise the Lord. There are some paintings that when you do that, and the moment people see you, they identify you as one of them. Praise God. You put on your dress, and the dress that you put down tight, top tight, side tight. And then you stand in the mirror, you tell yourself, and then you make your hair. And then as you are looking in the mirror, the Spirit of God begin to rebuke you as a Christian. So this dress that you are putting on to go out, how will the dress speak to the unbelievers? How will the dress speak about you as a child of God? Praise the Lord. But instead of you agreeing with the Spirit, you ignore the Spirit. And then you go out with that dress. You go out and men begin to look at you. They begin to call you. Hallelujah. And then you begin to say, why is it that, you know, men are disturbing me like that? Why? Leave me alone. But you don't know that it is your own dressing that is calling them. Praise the Lord. And some of these men, the eye that they have is not a good eye, so. The eye that they will look to look at you, and they look at you, they are throwing things. And by the time you turn back home, hallelujah, you are full with lust. Praise God. Why? Because you have left yourself vulnerable in the hand of the enemy to play you about. You were standing in the mirror. Praise the Lord. And when you were dressing, the Spirit of God rebuked you. Instead of you agreeing with the Spirit of God to change, hallelujah, you overlook. And the more you overlook, you hear the voice of the Spirit. It will come to a point that the Spirit of God will not speak again. Hallelujah. It will not speak again. Because you have killed the voice of the Spirit. He has spoken unto you. He has spoken unto you. He has appealed unto you. He has used men even to warn you. But yes, sir. I quite remember I went to a program somewhere. And when I went to that program, there was a lady who came to share the word. And when that lady came to stand at the stage, when you look at the lady from the top to the feet, the dressing, I believe, is what was catching the attention of the people. You can see everything about her. The trouser that she has worn has drawn her figure. The top that she has worn has drawn her figure. And she was standing in the pulpit and preaching. And all what I can see from the faces of the people is that the message was good, it was powerful, but people's attention was on him, person upon her. They were